Hi, Alex here from Rebeloper.com and welcome back to our tutorial series about saving, uploading, downloading, taking UI images on Swift 5. Now, in the previous episodes, we have taken care of saving images into your device and onto your photo library and a custom album. So go ahead and take a look at those if you already haven't done so. And today we are going to finally start working on uploading our image to Firebase storage, and then of course we will be downloading it to our app. Now today I am going to talk about the whole Firebase setup. So there won't be a lot of code today, but we are going to finally set up Firebase so it can work with this app. As you already know, we have added our pod files and we have installed them. So that's been taken care of. So now we want to go to Firebase. So go ahead and go to your Firebase console and we are going to create a brand new app. So click on that plus button and let's name this. And I want to name this Swift Image Mania. And that is correct. So there we go. And I accept all of the terms. So let's create our project here. And yeah, that is what we want to do. And we, well, this is kind of a time consuming process, but yeah, it is really fast. It depends on your internet connection. So let's hit continue there. And we are taken to our starter page here. And what we want to do first is create an app. And it will be, of course, an iOS app. So let's click on there. And first of all, we need our bundle ID. So let's grab that. There we go. Let's go to general and copy and paste that into our browser. There we go. Let's click on register app and we should be able to download our config file. So click on download Google service info playlist file and that will download it to your downloads. Let's go back to Xcode and just simply grab that and drag and drop it onto your project. Make sure copy items if needed is checked, create groups is checked, and Swift Image Mania the target is checked. So click on finish there. And now you can see that we have this fifth Google service info. If you are downloading a lot of info playlist files, yeah, that will be how it goes, but just simply need to delete it like so. Make sure Google service info plist is the name. Okay, let's go back to our browser, click on next, and let's add our Firebase SDK. Well, we already have done that, so let's click on next, and now we need to import Firebase, and yeah, this is kind of redundant, I believe, so let's go ahead and type that in our app delegate. So let's select our Xcode, select app delegate, and let's import and Firebase core. Yeah, so not just Firebase, Firebase core. Well, Firebase will most probably update their documentation if you are watching this in the future. So next up, let's go to our application did finish launching with options function, and there just type in Firebase app.configure and that is it. Okay, let's do the next steps. Let's click on next and skip this verification of installation because we are pretty sure that all of this worked. Now, what we need to enable is the database and the storage. And yeah, we are not going to use authentication because that is a whole another topic and it's quite time consuming. So what I will do to make access to our database and storage, and I will open it up so we can anybody can read and write, but that is a really, really bad idea if you are doing this in production. So yeah, this is just for testing purposes and the purpose of this tutorial. So let's take care of the storage first. So click on get started here. And as you can see, the security rules allow read and write if the requester has an authorization. So let's click on got it, because yeah, we can't do anything else, but we can change the rules here. And I will just simply delete all of that if statement. So let's publish it. Yeah, it will say that, okay, now it is a bad, this is a bad rule. You don't really want this, but hey, this is just for testing purposes. Now let's go to our database and let's use Cloud Firestore, because yeah, the newest and shiniest database from Firebase is Cloud Firestore, and we are going to use that. So let's click on create the database and let's start in test mode. As you can see, allow read and write to all. Okay, let's enable that. And once that is done, let's check on these rules. And yeah, it most probably it is okay. Now we can change this if we wanted to, but I don't want to mess with authentication for this tutorial, so we won't do that. Okay, now that we have done that, I believe we are ready with the setup. Okay, let's go back to Xcode and to our root view controller. And let me just guide you through what we are going to do in the next episodes. So we are going to upload our photo and then download it. Okay, so I hope you enjoyed this video. It was a short one, but a sweet one on how to set up your app to be able to use the Firebase APIs. And as usual, go ahead and give it a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and hit that notification bell. And I will see you shortly in the next one.